This is a crime, the city, and a wailing stagnation among the people. For behold, the darkness covers the earth, and gross darkness the people. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes, and they are laid in prison houses. They are for a prey, and none safe restore. Suddenly, comes a light and form of a word as a man to God's servant, saying, In that day shall there be an altar to the Lord in Africa, and a pillar at the border therefore in Johannesburg to the Lord. And it shall be for a sign and for a witness unto the Lord of hosts in Africa. For they shall cry unto the Lord because of the oppressors. And he shall send them a Savior, and a great one. And he shall deliver them.
Hello, my name is Pastor Tom, the senior pastor of Sikota
to reach out to the mental wood. I'm glad for you. I'm what?
I'm glad.
You are going to places.
Amen.
You are going where?
Places.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lord bless your name. Lord bless your name. I bring a word to you, title, My Grave Was Open. Say it.
My grave was open.
Say it loud.
My grave was open.
Tell your neighbor, say your grave was open.
Your grave was open.
Tell another neighbor, say your grave was open.
Your grave was open.
Is that not very strange? People of the Lord, this is the first time the Lord will give me this message in the entire of my gospel preaching. I've never preached this one. Why? Not because there is no word to preach. Not that I've not preached in big, large congregation, but God has a purpose for bringing me here.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I should have been in South Africa, but all of a sudden, it cost me something to be here. My flight was already booked for Tuesday to be in South Africa. But while I was in South Africa, the Lord said, I'm sending you to Godly Heritage Bible School after you had finished in Italy. I said, to do what? He said, when you get there, you will know what I'm saying.
Hallelujah.
So I went back to the, and I got there. I said, how much does it cost me to change? They gave me one ridiculous money, you know, expensive. I said, is that all? I said, please change my ticket to next Monday.
Hallelujah.
Why? And I called my wife. So it was not an agreement. And I called my wife. I said, baby, I've changed my ticket. He said, why? I said, God said I must be in that ministry.
Amen.
Because our appointment was to just see me and then disappear and then reappear and then. So God has a purpose for someone here.
Amen.
I am not a preacher. Hear me, people of the Lord. I am not a preacher. I can't preach like a father in the house. And I'm not here to impress you that I am a preacher, I am from South Africa, I am a Nigerian. No! If I dare speak any word of my own, let God close my mouth. But I'm here to send and to deliver a message. I'm only a messenger. Send to somebody a receiver.
Yeah.
I'm not a preacher. Is there anywhere that I have not, that your father in the Lord has not preached Many great men of God has come here and preach and preach, but I am not a preacher. Hear me, I am a prophetic errant of God.
Hallelujah.
I am the courier of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Your address and your name is in my hand. Address and your name is in my hand.
Amen.
I have a message for you.
Amen.
I have a courier for you.
Amen.
If you open this message, it will turn around.
Amen.
I don't know how to preach. I'm only a messenger. Because there is something you are expecting. There is something you have been waiting for. You have been looking for it. Who will give it to you? The courier of the Holy Ghost. I am a DHL of heaven.
Hallelujah.
Prophet a DHL of heaven. Prophet a danger of environment.
To give you a message.
Amen.
To give this church a message.
Amen.
To give an individual a message.
Amen.
Listen to me, I hear God this morning.
Amen.
You are a fertile land, but sitting on the grave land. I'm speaking to you as a church. You are sitting on a cursed land. I've never told you this. You are a fertile land, but you are sitting on a cursed land. Can I tell you, people of the Lord, even if you are not planning to leave this place, I send you out of this place. You have dwelt too long in your beginning.
Amen.
I hear the heaven speaking to me through this ministry.
Hallelujah.
Look at the name of your ministry. The Bible says, lines are falling unto me in pleasant places.
Yeah.
I heard the word, a goodly heritage. This is not your goodly heritage, sir. You are standing on your cost now. There is a competition of the Holy Spirit, which is not heading for you. I am sending you out.
Amen.
You have been forcing it, but right now, I am speaking to you. Whatever has made it to happen for one man, Rabolia Osita, Geroba, this has stand upon the altar of the Holy Ghost. This is the only message God has to do for you. I am fulfilled because I know. Before the end of this year,
Oluwa,
you are out of this
place.
And for you as an individual,
Oluwa,
you are in your grave.
You
are sleeping and dining and murmuring in your grave. What is the grave? You shall soon know that where you are standing upon your destiny is a stinking grief. God has sent me by the power of resurrection into your destiny.
Amen.
If I truly be a servant of the Lord, I declare to you, I declare to every stranger, I declare to every friend, come on! I so shall magnify the Lord. Oh yes, Lord.
I know it's daily.
You are an object of faith.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I speak as the Lord speaks to me from this hour, this ministry, Goodly Heritage Bible Church. I command you in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, move to your Goodly Heritage.
Amen.
Line must be falling into you in pleasant places, not in ugly places.
Amen.
Hear me, if you want me to say it raw, you are in a ugly place. It's your beginning. I thank God for it.
Hallelujah.
I was also in an ugly beginning, but the power of the Lord that called me exploded, erupted, and the grave opened, and the land cannot contain us.
Hallelujah.
Take your seat now. I don't know, oh God, why you always do this to me? Every time God sent me somewhere, when I go with my own message, He shut my mouth to prepare His own message.
Amen.
I think the Holy Spirit has overtaken this event right
now.
Amen.
Yes.
Prophetic utterance.
Amen. Amen.
I'm not a preacher, I'm a messenger. Hear me, and I declare again, God sent me to this ministry for a purpose. I didn't come here to raise offering. If I want to raise offering, there are many places I will raise offering. God forbid that I will raise offering to survive. Let me die that day that I will raise offering in the church to survive. Or to use spiritual way to cajole you for offering. Let me die that day. Why? I am blessed spiritually.
Amen.
Blessed and protected spiritually. And I'm speaking to the world right now, to the people listening to me in the TV and on the YouTube. I am spiritually blessed, financially covered, dangerously blessed and covered.
Amen.
I am not in the ministry to look for people £50 or £1,000 to survive or to live.
Amen.
Today I will say, give me £50 to survive. Let me die. I am in the financial authorities. I am in the financial blessing before God comes to the ministry. And he said, I will use you to be a blessing to others in the ministry. I was in the Paris, and I got there. I said, I preach on the screen. They said, what is screen? It's a big church. I said, okay, let's go to the market. Point your hands to the screen that you like. And I bought the screen. And I put her in the church. I went there to be a blessing.
Yeah.
And I said to them, people of God, if the Lord asked me to give all of you sitting here now, £1,000, He don't take anything.
Hallelujah.
From
you. Amen. You are dangerously blessed.
Blessed.
Hallelujah.
How can a man from Africa go to Europe and be a blessing and be showing the seed of TV plasma? The cloud of ministry has changed.
Amen.
Sir, any pastor that comes here or any prophet of the Lord that do not know their bearing, that want to come here and cajole you spiritually, I show the gate.
Amen.
In your small beginning, you are great.
Amen.
In your small beginning, you are great.
Amen.
And as long as you are seated upon this root, you are coming out.
Amen.
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 I'm excited God brought me here to speak a new word of life.
Hallelujah.
You are getting out of your grave.
Amen.
You are getting out of your grave.
Amen.
You are getting out of your grave.
Amen.
You heard the testimony of my brother that I called here. From Nigeria. Hear me, when we are in a small place like this. We've been looking for a large place for Terima because our explosion was abnormal. And I said to the Lord, Lord, people of the Lord, hear me. In the next 30 days, if God did not give us a big place, larger place to contain people of the Lord, I said in the next 30 days, God did not call me, then let me not fake it. Let people scatter. I told all of them, I said, all of you looking at me, if in the next 30 days we didn't find a bigger place, I said, every one of you, don't come to this church anymore. I am not called, I am fake. Go and look for anywhere to worship. You can even go to Babalawo or go to any place to worship. That means worship altar is fake. As I said that word, everybody put their hands on their heads like this. Pastor, how can you speak like this now?
Hello.
But if God called me, sir, I believe in your calling. I have seen you in the spiritual realm. You have a call. You have the heart for God.
Yes.
The God that has called you, if truly is a God of miracles, signs and wonders, let this word I'm speaking to you now in this ministry find a practical expression in this ministry before the end of this year.
Amen.
Amen.
How many months remaining?
3 months.
Is too much.
Yes.
Say 3 months are too much.
3 months are too much.
And I step into my friend, my son ministry. I call him my son because he humbled himself. And I stand, and I stood, I say, in the name of Jesus, if you are truly called, I'm saying the same thing to you.
Amen.
People of the Lord, look at this man. If he's truly called, and if as I'm standing in the same faith with him, because as water answers unto water faces, so is the heart of man. If my heart is truly connected with this family, if he's truly a man of God, watch it before the end of this year. 3 months, too much. If he's truly called of God, you are out of this place.
Amen.
Amen.
How many of you still like this place?
No, no.
Do you still like this place?
No.
So that means we are in the spirit.
Yes.
I command you out.
Amen.
I command you out.
Amen.
Why? Your grave is
open.
Oh, my grave is open.
My grave is open.
My grave is open.
My grave is open.
Jesus.
How can a dead man in the grave speak life to somebody that is alive? You cannot be in a grave and you expected a life
to enter.
Therefore, right now, I speak. Because if the power that is Jesus Christ dwelleth in you. Which I know dwelling here.
Yes.
It will quicken the mortal bodies.
Amen. Amen.
It will quicken the accursed land.
Amen.
There is a contention in this land. There is a spiritual contention. Merely entering this place, I have done the spiritual mapping. I don't know how many prophets of God has entered here and did spiritual mapping. I have seen the spiritual. I thank God for where you started because God wants to manifest himself. I want to have you a base. But now you have dwelt too long right now. It's an accursed land. And then you must move to your place of glory.
Amen.
It might mean that somebody will be blessed in this ministry.
Amen.
That will take this crusade.
Amen.
See, open your heart right now. Everyone sitting here, open your heart. Lord, your prophet is speaking. I might be the one you will use. And I spoke to
them.
I said, I won't come back to this place. The place is 2 times this place, actually. And I said, I won't come back here. To this place. I didn't know you were speaking for a place. And I said, in the next 3 months, if God truly called me, and this is 3 months again to the end of this year, God that has done it in my ministry, in that my ministry, and you are the third person I'm going to speak to right now, then.
Hallelujah, it is done.
Amen.
So when we spoke in our ministry, it was on Wednesday. On Thursday, say less than 24 hours.
Less than 24 hours.
We spoke at 8 p.m. and at 8 a.m. I got a call from estate agent. Say, Pastor Tao, please come and look at this baby. Maybe you will like it. I got there. I stood there. The Lord said, this is the place of the people.
Hallelujah.
3 times bigger than this place. Or 4 times. Maybe 5 times. less than 24
hours.
Wednesday. And then on Sunday, we announced, people of the Lord, congratulations, we are moving out.
Hallelujah.
We didn't do the service there the following Sunday.
Hallelujah.
No place. So how does it happen? Where was the place before the time? You see, when prophets speak, everything hear, everything obey.
Yes.
Because prophets are mouthpiece of heaven. I speak to this ministry. Oh head. Hear ye the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. I command the grief of this ministry.
Amen.
I command the grave of this ministry open.
Amen.
I command your grave open.
Amen.
You have dwelt too long. And it's time for God to overturn your story.
Amen.
God is overturning your story.
Amen.
I said God is overturning your story. My grave must open.
My grave
is a land of mockery. I might not even look at my laptop to give you this word the way you will understand. Let's talk about it. There are two types of graves. Say two types of graves. One, we have spiritual grave. We have spiritual grief. And Mama has said one. The physical grief is the market. The physical grief is what?
Market.
Where you are what? Trading. Selling and buying. Do you know in the market, there are many people in the market. You find the dead body, you find the ghost, everything is there, trading in the market. Do you know that? That is physical. The market and trade upon you, and then what happened? Market disappear, market disappear, market disappear, market. That's why you see when you are in the physical grave, destiny appear, disappear. Blessing appear, disappear. Blessing today, closer tomorrow. You are in the physical enclosement. Every time you find yourself in the spiritual grave, which is what Mama was talking about, the grave. Ah, sir, you need Jesus to enter into that temple and cast out the spirit of blindness. You needed what?
Jesus Christ.
And now, Jesus said, now that I am no longer in the physical, I am sending my prophet to you. Because as my Father has sent me, so sent I you, the prophet of the Lord. And he said, he went into the temple. And the temple is the heart of the man. He went inside to the temple. He sent me to your temple here to clean up every marketing system. Say,
I receive.
Put this word to enter your spirit mind consciously, not distracting you by opening and opening. Everything is here. Let me speak to you as son, hearing his father, and as mother, speaking to his daughter, so that you can know and enter a new beginning. The grave must open by force, by what?
By fire.
Prophet are agent of grave opener. Hear me. In the physical grave, you have the ability, men have the ability to open and to close. But there is another grave that the Holy Spirit only have the ability to open and flow. It is the spiritual grave. I've given you two types of graves. Physical, the spiritual. Can I tell how many of you slept yesterday and and woke up this morning? Can I see your hand? You slept yesterday night and you woke up this morning. Did you know that you are in the spiritual grave? Why are you seated here now? Because there is power of living
inside of us,
inside of you.
Amen.
That grows you all. That's why it's if the spirit and grace of Jesus Christ, if it dwelleth in you, it dwelleth in you. Jesus also went to the grave, but the grave vomited him.
Yes.
You are being to grave 24/7, you are in the grave of the devil. That's why you can sleep. And when you sleep, do you know what happened? There was something going on when you are sleeping. The witches and the wizard begin to give the operation. The spiritual husband, the spiritual wife, the nightmare begin to do the operation. You are in the grave, but they thought they are going to condemn you. They are going to silence you. But God has the power, ability to raise you up. And today is your confirmation for the power of the resurrection upon you.
Amen.
God sent me there to open the grave. Spiritual grave. Spiritual grave. Spiritual grave is more dangerous than the physical grave. Because the physical grave, men have the ability and the power to control it. But the spiritual grave, only power of the Lord to control it. And by the power of the Lord, God sent prophet and his agent to rule the physical spiritual. People of the Lord. And then, I always say to people, you can't give what you don't have.
Yes.
If I don't have life in me, I can't give the life to you. I am, to the glory of the Lord, one of the accredited sons of the prophets to this generation to unveil the mysteries of supernatural explosion. That the devil cannot comprehend. This morning, every of your spiritual graves, Lero Braketo Sisi Yaga Prade Yalo Shita Yandala Brati Yalo Soleya. I command the open now!
Amen!
Yes! Of your spiritual graves. Everything that has holding you, or that are holding you in the spiritual grave, I command Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
I command Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
I command Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
In your personal life.
Amen.
In your physical life.
Amen.
In your marital life.
Amen.
In your academic.
Amen.
Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
Consume every grave.
Amen.
Jesus
name.
Hello, people of the Lord.
Hi.
Lazarus went into the grave for how many days? For how many days?
3 days.
Jesus went into the grave for how many days? I want to tell you something. God sent me to all the Lazarus in the house this morning. God sent me to all the Lazarus in the house this morning. Jesus, the controller of the spirit, overcame the grave.
Hallelujah.
By the power of the Holy Ghost. Nobody woke Jesus up. It was the Spirit of God Himself that woke him up. The Bible says, and Martha and Mary was going to the sepulchre. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
I don't want to open anything for you. You are born a woman of knowledge. And the Bible says, and they reasoned within themselves. Say, who shall roll away this stone? Who shall what? Roll away this stone. And the Bible says, and it was in the morning, the first day of the week. Are you in the third day of the week right now?
First day.
That's what I know. This morning is yours.
Amen.
The reason within themselves. I don't know what you are reasoning within yourself. Who shall roll away this stone? This stone is heavy. This thing is heavy in my life. No job, no paper, no permit, no husband, no wife, no career, no children, barrenness. It is a grave. you are finding yourself. Mm. And you are asking yourself, who's that roll away this stone? But God asked me to tell you, He has sent me to roll away the stone.
Amen.
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 The power that was upon Jesus. Jesus transferred it unto me. Because no one could roll his own stone. The Holy Spirit rolled the stone. And now Jesus himself was sent to Lazarus. Lazarus was in the grave. He was in his market. The devil was playing around him. Wicked Satan. Destroy Lazarus. The Bible says, and he was a closer friend of Jesus. Hmm. As many of you that are closer sons and daughters of this ministry, the time has come for you.
Amen.
The time is now
Amen.
For you to step out
Amen.
Of your grave.
Amen.
Amen.
And he called. Mary said, let's call for him, his friend. When his friends arrive here, matter, there was an argument. Who shall roll away the stone? Also, can you see? He said, but this one is for this day. But his friend, Jesus Christ, arrived the scene. The friend of your pastor arrived the scene.
Hallelujah.
Tell me. Can the grave stop Jesus? And Jesus cried. And he looked at the grave. Lazarus, what are you doing in the grave? First thing, he said, roll away what? The stone. The stone was the mockery of Lazarus. The stone was the mockery of Jesus. They said, let us roll the stone into the sepulchre. By adventure, these boys will go and open it. And say, as resurrected. So the stone was the door that was closed against Jesus. The same stone was the grave against Lazarus. Jesus said to the grave, he said, take away the stone. Before I could do any miracle, take away the stone. And I'm speaking to you right now. Take away the stone out of your life. Take away dirtiness. Take away murmuring. Take away blasphemy. Take away lukewarmness to God. Take away gossiping. Gossiping of your pastor, of your pastor's wife, of your friends, of your neighbor, take away the stone. Take away the stone of offenses. Can't you see? You are full of offenses. You are even angry with God. Hey, yes, I've been to brutally everything. What has happened in my life? Now I'm living. And if you want to leave, great. You don't know your root, so I won't blame you if you are not getting your fruit. If you truly know your root, you will water your root, and then you will receive your fruit. The reason why you are not getting your fruit is because you are not watering your fruit, your root. You are murmuring inside your root. You are complaining under your root. Take away this complaint. Take away this murmuring. I'm speaking to someone here this morning. Take away the spirit of doubt. Have confidence in this ministry. Throw not away your confidence in this man, in this woman of God. With us a great recompense of what? Reward. Everyone that has left here is because they didn't know their roots. And check them, they have not found their fruit. Check them, everyone that has left here, they don't know their root. They are under the spiritual market. texting, and when you are doing around, you can't get a first.
But for you, I'm speaking to you. If you know your root, you will enjoy your fruit. This is your root. Stay by it. Take away every stone. What is stone? Hard-heartedness. Take it off from tonight, from this morning, or this afternoon. Take away lack of faith. Release yourself.
Can I be a financial pillar? How can I be a financial pillar? Don't you know how can I be a financial pillar? Hey, let me ask you a question. How many of you live in your house without buying grocery? How many of you live in your house without having a plasma? But your church does not have plasma. How many of you are not paying rent in your house? All of you are paying rent. But how many of you are concerned about the rent of this church? How many of you take this as a business, the way you take your own shop, your work as a business, and you want God to bless you? When there is a stone, when you are very, you know, another stone that keeps the church, spiritual stinginess. Oh, you need to check your tithing book, you need to check your tithing record. Are you a tither? Are you a giver? I give more than anything in my church. And I'm blessed by it.
Hallelujah.
The only thing that God, the answer to financial breakthrough, is financial covenant. People of the Lord, no matter how small you are, I'm not here to raise offering, but I'm taking you out of your grave. And I'm telling you, remove the stone and out. Holy Spirit, come and dwell in me. Holy Spirit, come and dwell in me. Holy Spirit, come and dwell in me. I do need alive. Take out your Bible. Isaiah chapter 18. I want us to raise all the Bible now, and then we'll pray upon this altar, and then in the grave will open automatically.
God sent me into this nation to raise altars of life, to close the grave of affliction in our lives.
Are you there?
Yes,
sir. Isaiah chapter 19, we read to verse 20. Can we read together?
The burden of Jesus
build.
The Lord rises upon his fifth cloud.
Hello, Isaiah 19. Did I say?
Yes,
verse 19.
In that day,
many.
In that day shall there be an altar of the Lord in the midst of the land of Egypt, and a pillar at the border thereof to the Lord. And it shall be for a sign and for a witness unto the Lord of hosts in the land of Egypt. For they shall cry unto the Lord because of the oppressors, and he shall send them a Savior, and a great one, and he shall deliver them.
Write this story like this. I am an accredited God author Lisa. He gave me an assignment under the mandate of author. He said, get thee out of your father's land. I am from Una's family by spiritual birth. I came from a lineage of giants. So I cannot remain or be a dwarf. Elephant give birth to elephant.
Yes.
Lion give birth to lion. My greatness is from my spiritual heritage. I speak the same thing to him. And he sent me with a mandate, with a rod of altar. Right now, I'm going to raise a new beginning, a new altar in this ministry. And I write it like this. Follow me from your own Bible. In that day, in that day,
in that day,
in that day,
When is that day?
Say today.
Shall there be an altar?
Shall there be an altar
to the Lord?
To the Lord
in the land of United Kingdom.
In the land of the United Kingdom.
And a pillar.
And a pillar.
At Wisdom Exploit House.
At the Wisdom Exploit House.
Amen. Godly Heritage Ministry.
Godly Heritage Ministry.
Amen. To the Lord.
To the Lord.
What would that be? And it shall be.
And it shall be.
For a sign.
For a sign.
And for a witness.
And for a witness.
Unto the Lord of hosts.
Unto the Lord of hosts.
We are in the United Kingdom.
We are in the United Kingdom.
And when the altar is raised, for they shall cry unto the Lord.
For they shall cry unto the Lord.
Because of the
oppressors.
Because of who?
Of the oppressors. Oppressors.
Because of who?
Oppressors.
And they shall weep unto the Lord. Eh? They shall weep. Is that what is there? They shall weep.
Yes, sir.
They shall cry. They shall cry.
Yes, sir.
And they shall laugh.
No.
Huh?
No.
They shall play.
No.
And they shall gist.
No.
They shall have faith.
No.
They shall what?
Cry.
They shall cry. What is cry? They shall lift up their voice to the Lord. And what? He will hear them.
Yes.
Huh? And then he will send them what?
A savior.
Not only that he's going to send them a savior, but
a man.
A what?
A great one.
Not only that is going to send them a savior, but a
great
one. I am a great one of the Lord. Send to you. And what? After he sent the great one, he shall deliver them from all their
oppressors.
From all their
oppressors.
From all their
oppressors.
Poverty is an oppressor.
Yes.
He shall deliver them.
Amen.
Poverty is an oppressor. He shall deliver
Amen.
Them. Limitation is an oppressor. He shall deliver them.
Amen.
Lack of words is an oppressor. He shall deliver
Amen.
Them.
Amen.
Ooh, a great one.
Amen.
Limitation is an
oppressor. Oh, yes.
Landlord is an oppressor.
Oh, yes.
Landlady is an oppressor.
Yes.
Joblessness is an oppressor.
Yes.
HIV is an oppressor.
Yes.
Barrenness is an oppressor.
Yes.
Leukemia is an oppressor.
Yes.
Cancer is an oppressor
Yes.
of your body.
Yes.
Deafness, blindness
Yes.
is an oppressor of your body.
Yes.
Huh? Is an oppressor. Don't you see how many married men are oppressing you? And they are mocking you. Where is the husband? Where is the wife? They are oppressing you.
Every oppression.
But God is taking you now
over my life.
From your grave to your heart to your face.
Amen.
Hear me as I conclude, because you will lift up your voice right now. When Lazarus rose from the grave, he became what? Famous.
Yes.
Is that not what the Bible told us? When Lazarus, he arose, Jesus Christ, he arose for me. When Lazarus rose from the grave, he became famous. Your grave is to make you brave.
Amen.
Your grave is to make the braveness of you. Your grave is to make you famous.
Amen.
Do I have usher in this place?
Oh yes, sir.
Somebody must minister with me. I'm going to another prophetic realm now. You know what? I'm speaking to you also.
Yes, sir.
Your grave. Your grave. Yes. Rice. Aha. Rice. 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 Rice from your grave.
Amen.
I command the spirit of rising.
Amen.
Rice!
Amen.
Rice! Rise up! Every limitation. Rise up! I command that limitation. Be broken.
Amen.
Be broken.
Amen.
Be broken.
Amen.
Rise now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lazarus rose.
Do you know what the Bible says? And after Lazarus rose, the following day or the following Sunday, the Bible says, and the people gathered to hear Jesus. Not only to hear him, but to see root Lazarus that was risen from the grave.
Yes.
Next Sunday. I said next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Fire! Loose! From my hand to the door! Now! In the name of Jesus! Come! Next Sunday! Hey, hey! Amen. You can't resist the Jew stranger. Please, I'm going to pack all the chairs in the back. I'm going to pack all the chairs in the back. You can't resist the Jew false spirit of the devil. Get out! You spirit of oppression.
Amen.
Get out now. I command you. You stranger. You stranger. Amen. You stranger.
Amen.
I said get out.
Amen.
You stranger.
Amen.
I said get out. Who are you?
Amen.
Get out!
Amen.
Oh, yellow Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Who are you?
Amen.
Loser now.
Amen.
Fire all over our body.
Amen.
Get out!
Amen.
I command you!
Amen.
Now!
Amen.
Aha.
Amen.
Turn around.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I command every authority. Every authority in this body.
Amen.
Against our growth, against our education.
Amen.
Every limitation, everything limiting your growth.
Amen.
Loose Anna.
Amen.
Every grave.
Amen.
Lift up your voice, everybody, and say, every grave.
Every grave.
Of my life.
Of my life.
Right now.
Right now.
Open.
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 Every grave. Of my life. Grave.
Of
finances.
Open.
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 Every grave.
Every grave.
Of finances.
Open.
Open.
Gate
of career.
Career.
Every grave. That's limited me.
I am a prisoner of the grace of God. I am a prisoner of the grace of God.
Let that be a new beginning in my life. A new chapter be opened in my life. Every mockery, oh God. Every mockery has been cancelled over my life. Every limitation has been cancelled over my life. You are the name of Jesus. Everlasting Father, King of Glory, I just say thank you.
It is done. Right now, I want us to command every grain of mockery, everything that has been mocking me,
anyone that has been mocking me, And she refused.
How did you
she
enter?
She left that house.
How did you enter?
Me, Baba.
How did you enter?
I gave her to her. I know how to enter. You know how to ask.
Okay, now you have to go out. You have to go out. Then you have to go out. Then you have to go out. Okay, now. In the name of the Father, the Son. Get out of this body now. Your time is over. 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 Fire.
over your body.
Amen.
You stranger. Fire all over your hands. Fire all over your hands.
Fire.
Fire all over your hands. Fire. Somebody must
Amen.
Mama, we are you? You want to stay? You say fire.
Fire.
Amen. Get out.
Amen.
Loose and out.
Amen.
Be loose.
Amen.
Be loose.
Amen.
Amen.
Silence.
Who are you? I'm going to be this stranger. Let me take this book. Let me take this marriage. Every evil covenant is broken now. Every evil covenant now is broken. Receive the fire of the Holy Ghost from all your head to your toes. Be delivered right now, right now, right now. Every stranger. Get out of this body now. Fire of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
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 Grave open.
Amen.
Every hidden place. Every hidden covenant.
Amen.
Get out.
Amen.
Say, I separate myself.
Pray myself.
From every covenant.
From every covenant.
Of evil.
Of evil.
Right now, I take authority over strangers in my life. I receive new life of Christ Jesus. I am free. Deliver. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every one of you lift up your voice, Amen. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Everything.
Everything.
Mocking my Christian life.
Mocking my Christian life.
Everything.
Everything.
The work of the devil.
The work of the devil.
Ancestral spirit.
Ancestral spirit.
Every voice.
Every voice.
From my family.
From my family.
From my village.
From my village.
From my country.
From my country.
Controlling me.
Controlling me.
Every controlling power.
Every controlling power.
Broken down.
And broken down.
Now.
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 I am free.
I am going to the top.
I am going to the top.
This thing
ministry
is going to the door.
His ministry
is going to the door.
In the name of Jesus.
Come and give the Lord a clap for him.
Here is waiting for the permit from the home office. From the home office, come. I have a gift.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You are still waiting for me. You are waiting for permit. You are waiting for permit.
Oh no, sir.
Permit.
Nah.
If God give it, I've shared a testimony for you. This is a diplomatic passport for me. This is a get your hand. As the law broke protocol from Zambia for me to enter without visa, this is the same key of David.
Amen.
As it reaches your hand, everywhere your permit is stopped. Again, open office.
Amen.
How would you know that God sent me? It is the power that is in me that
will come.
Don't do it. Edit. Do it. Okay. It's a gift. Take it. It's a gift. Huh? Take it. It's a gift. It's a key. That's the key.
Amen.
That's okay.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen.
It's good. It's good. It's good. Do you know me in the spirit? Do you know me in the spirit? Who am I in the spirit? Who am I in the spirit?
Servant of God.
Who say it to you?
The Holy Ghost.
Who say it to you?
The Holy Ghost.
DK.
Hey.
DK. Who say it to you? DK. For your son, I swear, for your son. Amen. For your son. And the other can find it.
Amen.
I saw Kenneth being threatened by God from the police. You have received everything because you want nothing. You have
Amen.
I can see everything.
Amen.